So if you notice that you're getting gassy when having veggies, Google cruciferous veggies, print out the list, bring it to a tattoo parlor, and say, "Tattoo the names of all of these veggies on the inside of my eyelids so that I never eat them again." Hello, my honeys, it's Emmy. If you're new to the channel, welcome. My name is Emmy. I'm a nutritionist and the creator of the Slim On Starch program, where you work with me, your mindset coach, and your nutrition coach so that you can lose weight on a starch-based, plant-based diet. So if you are interested in that, go to healthyemmy.org or just click the link in the down bar. Also, make sure to hit subscribe and turn on the notification bell so that you can be notified every time the freshest news on plant-based weight loss is coming at you live. Today, I am talking about bloating on a plant-based diet. This is so common, honeys. I get DMs all the time from people saying, "I literally look like I'm 6 months pregnant on this lifestyle." And you know damn well that you are not 6 months pregnant because you were in Target the other day and you saw a kid screaming his head off and you said, "Not doing that." I'm just kidding. It was Home Goods that you saw the kid in. Okay, enough of my dry stand-up comedy. Let's get into the video about bloating. This is gonna be a long one. There are a lot of reasons that people are bloated on a plant-based lifestyle, but we're gonna talk about all of them. Let's do it. Reason number one why you're bloated is because you are new to a plant-based lifestyle. This plant-based, starch-based diet is very high in water and fiber, and it requires your digestive muscles to be very strong. If you come from a diet where you're not eating all of these whole foods in their whole form, in their whole unprocessed form, then your digestive system might be kind of asleep right now and in hibernation. Processed foods don't require our stomach and our digestive system to do as much work. But when we give our digestive system these foods that are in their whole unprocessed form, our digestive system has to get to work to deal with all that fiber and all of that water and all of the bulk that comes along with this lifestyle so that it can get to the nutrients. It has to do a lot of digging, and the food hasn't already been processed. When you eat processed food, the digestion was done for you in the processing plant. When you eat whole unprocessed foods, your stomach has to do what it was built for, but likely it wasn't having to do what it was built for a long time before that. So your stomach muscles are getting back to work. It's just like when you start to go to the gym again and you start working out again, your muscles are like, "Whoa, it's been a while," and you're sore. This is why you have this bloating when you come to this lifestyle. And the cure to it, the way to get out of it, is to give it time. And watch the rest of this video because there's likely other things that you're doing. But if you're new to this lifestyle, it's not abnormal to have this bloating. It will go away with time as your stomach muscles become stronger, but you gotta stick with it, and the bloating does get better if you also incorporate the other tips that I'm gonna talk about in this video. Reason number two is that you're coming from a restrictive dieting past. Not necessarily severe restriction, but any form of dieting in which you don't eat large quantities of food. What I love about this lifestyle is that you get to eat a lot of food. And if you're coming from a diet where you didn't do that, just like we talked about before, your stomach doesn't know what to do with all this food because it hasn't had to deal with it for all this time. So your stomach muscles are like, "Whoa, I don't know what to do with all this. Let me catch up to the fact that you're eating all of this food again." If you're coming from a diet where you were eating very small portions of food and now you're eating a lot of food, well, of course you're going to experience that your stomach is saying, "Whoa, oh, I gotta catch up to all of this," and you'll experience a little bit of bloating. On that note, I think it's important for me to also note that we want to be realistic when it comes to what we expect our stomach to look like when we're eating food. If you have a backpack and there's nothing in the backpack's gonna be flat. When you put things in the backpack's gonna be full. It's the same thing with our stomach. At the end of the day, when you have more food in your stomach is gonna be a little bit bigger. That is normal. We shouldn't have these unrealistic expectations that we're gonna have a flat stomach every second of every day. If we're putting food in our stomach is going to be a little bit bigger, and that is okay. That's how we nourish our bodies. So that's absolutely fine. And I just wanted to put in that note as well because it's important to note. So what do we do if we're coming from this past of sort of restrictive yo-yo dieting? Consistency, patience, and committing to this process is big. Just relax. The gut is the second brain. And so if you're all up in arms about this and you're all tense about this, your stomach is going to react that way as well. And that bloating is just going to continue and it will never go away. So be consistent, be patient, trust this process as you come to this new wonderful lifestyle of abundance, and your stomach will catch up with it. Another reason for bloating, which I see all the time, is eating too quickly. Two things happen when we eat too quickly. First, we swallow a bunch of air. That air gets trapped in our stomach and we bloat and we get gassy, one way or the other. The second reason is that you're not chewing your food enough. So in our mouth, in our saliva, there are digestive enzymes that help break down that food so that by the time it gets to our stomach, it's ready to go. If we don't chew the food enough and we don't allow those digestive enzymes to mix around with the food, then by the time it gets to our stomach, it's not ready to be there. It's sort of like you've shown up to your wedding and your hair and your makeup isn't done. You're not ready to go. That's the same thing that happens if the food is not chewed fully in our stomach. So you need to chew your food to a paste. It sounds disgusting, and it is. Food and paste, ugh, I don't want to see it. But that's why your stomach sees it. And it's so, so important to make sure that you're chewing your food slowly, chew, 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 get on that choo-choo train so that you A, don't swallow too much air, and B, by the time that your food gets to your stomach, it's ready to be digested. Because if you eat too quickly and you swallow that food before it's ready to be digested, your stomach goes on overdrive and it has so much to do. And by the end, it's inflamed, which is why you're experiencing that bloating. The next reason is you're not drinking enough water. Water allows the digestive system to be nice and lubricated so that food can actually move through it. Again, to get that food moving, let's get drinking so that it's not all dry, just trying to move along there. This is very easy to picture visually. It's like if you're going down a water slide, you know how when you go to the water park and if you don't really catch the water, you can kind of get stuck in the slide, your tube gets stuck? That's the same thing that's going to happen with your food in your intestines, which is going to cause your stomach to be distended. So by drinking, you're allowed to push that tube through the tubes, the tube through the tubes. Yeah, no, that's what it is. So by drinking water, you're able to push that food through your digestive tract, just like you push that tube through the tube at the water park. Very simple. Make sure you're drinking enough water. How much water do you need to drink? Take your body weight in pounds, cut it in half. That's how many ounces you need to be drinking. Take your body weight in kilos. That's how many ounces you need to be drinking. So let's say you're 70 kilos, drink 70 ounces. If you're 150 pounds, drink 75 ounces. Not exercising and not moving. When we exercise, blood flows to our muscles. Guess what? Your digestive system, it's made up of a bunch of muscles. So by getting blood flowing and moving to those muscles, you're gonna allow the food to be digested. Very simple. If exercise is not a priority and it's not part of your daily routine, make it a part of your daily routine. I know that a lot of people like to use the loo in the morning, so make movement a part of every morning. Stress. Stress is a huge, huge reason for bloating. When we're stressed, the body has some pretty severe physiological responses. Blood will flow away from the digestive system, and the sympathetic nervous system will make this happen because it perceives that the body has other things that it needs to attend to, and the digestive system is not one of them. Have you ever heard the saying, you know, I nearly pooped my pants, I was so nervous? Where do you think that comes from? It comes from the fact that when we are feeling threatened, stressed, nervous, when our emotions are running high, blood flows right away from that digestive system because there are other things that you need to do, like run away from a predator. That's what your primal brain says. So being stressed, the gut is the second brain, and being stressed is going to cause digestive issues up the wazoo. So make de-stressing a part of every single day. Unplug from technology, from your job, go for a walk, allow yourself to breathe. Just take a moment, and if you don't have 5 minutes to do that, then you likely need to do it for at least 10. Gum chewing. Oh my goodness, there are so many reasons why gum chewing is the worst if you are bloated. Reason number one is that you swallow a bunch of air. When you swallow a bunch of air, it's gotta go somewhere, and it's gonna sit in your stomach, and then it's gonna go one way or the other. The second reason, gum usually is packed with artificial sweeteners, and artificial sweeteners wreak havoc on the digestive system. It's going to cause bloating. Reason number three why chewing gum sucks if you're experiencing bloating is because it triggers the digestive system to start moving. So your digestive system is going to turn on. It's going to say, all right, we are here. We are ready to go. Let's do it. Let's go. It's time for us to start digesting food. So picture it this way. Picture like somebody's asleep in bed. Okay. So the covers are over them. They're asleep and they're sound asleep. Then it's time for them to wake up. They get up, they stretch, they jump out of bed. This is what your digestive system has just done because you're chewing gum. But guess what? There's no food there. So your digestive system is up and it's moving and it's ready to go and nothing's happening. So just like if you picture your bed, how your bed has those covers over it, if you're dead asleep, the covers are gonna be nice and flat. But once you get up and you stretch your arms, same thing is happening with your stomach. Consuming artificial sweeteners. Artificial sweeteners wreak havoc on the gut. Studies show that just 1 milligram per liter, just 1 milligram per liter of artificial sweeteners causes the bacteria in the gut to become toxic. What? That is insanity. That is how sensitive we are to artificial sweeteners. I do not stand them. So artificial sweeteners are going to cause the bacteria in your gut to become toxic, which of course is going to lead to bloating. Get rid of those artificial sweeteners. Use fruit, the whole fruit, nothing but the fruit instead. Swap it out. Eating too many cruciferous veggies. Cruciferous veggies, that is your broccoli, your cabbage, your Brussels sprouts, your kale, cauliflower. You can just Google, what are the cruciferous veggies? Those ones are going to cause gas and bloating. They contain something called raffinose, which is a sugar that remains undigested in the stomach until it gets to the gut and the bacteria takes care of it. And when it does, it lets out some pretty disgusting gas. So if you notice that you're getting gassy when having veggies, Google cruciferous veggies, print out the list, bring it to a tattoo parlor and say, tattoo the names of all of these veggies on the inside of my eyelids so that I never eat them again. I'm kidding. You don't have to avoid them for the rest of your life, but just be wary of them and know that those ones in particular do cause a little bit of gas. Eating foods that are new to you. If you are eating new foods that you haven't eaten before, it's likely that you'll experience some gas, bloating, indigestion, because the gut in our bacteria eats what we eat, and the gut in our bacteria is what allows us to digest food. Well, the gut in our bacteria is determined by what our current diet is. So if we eat new foods, then we might not have the bacteria in our gut to digest those foods. So for the time being, it's going to be a little bit difficult until we build up that bacteria. So when introducing new foods, introduce them slowly so that you can build up that bacteria in your gut and avoid bloating. Beans. Beans are absolutely infamous for bloating. If you're noticing that beans are making you bloated, you're not alone. And I would encourage you to reincorporate them into your diet. So take a break from them and then reincorporate them very, very slowly. You could even do 1 bean a day, 2 beans a day, maybe a teaspoon of beans per day. Slowly reincorporate them. Also, make sure that your beans are actually cooked all the way. A lot of the beans that you buy that are canned, they're not cooked all the way. So cook them again for a second time so that they're easier to digest. Beans also contain something really cool called oligosaccharides. They sound really cool, but they're kind of evil because it's a sugar that the body has trouble breaking down. And so if you find that beans, like, you just can't do it, then take some Beano, because Beano contains the enzyme that's needed to break down that sugar, so it can help you with the gas. Consuming breath mints, Tic Tacs, Altoids, probably gonna sue me for this video. That's okay. These are no good when it comes to digestion. They likely contain artificial sweeteners, which we talked about those guys earlier. They're no good. Sensitivity to gluten. I'm not a huge be gluten-free type of person because I don't think that it's totally necessary. The Slim on Starch program is naturally gluten-free because it's just all whole foods, and whole foods in their real natural form don't contain gluten. But you might have a sensitivity to gluten, and cross-contamination can occur in things like oats and rice. And so in that case, I would encourage you to make sure that you're getting everything that is certified gluten-free so that there's no cross-contamination if you do have celiac disease. If you have celiac disease, then you need to be gluten-free. But if you don't and you don't have any sensitivity to gluten, then there's no need for you to be gluten-free. But I wanted to throw that one in here. Eating too much fiber. If you are eating a ridiculous amount of fiber, fiber has bulk that the body cannot digest, so your stomach is going to be distended. So what I would suggest is peeling your fruits and vegetables because that's where all of the fiber is. If you take an apple and you peel the apple, the amount of fiber in that apple has reduced dramatically. Same thing with potatoes, same thing with any of those vegetables that you're eating. After peeling them, cook them very, very well. The more cooked a food is, the easier it is to digest, and stay away from those raw foods, which leads me into my next one, raw foods. If you find that you're consuming a lot of raw foods and having a lot of bloating, it's the fact that the food is raw that's the hardest for your body to digest. So cook that food very, very, very well. I often get asked, Emmy, how do you not get bloated? I cook my food like it's going out of style. Overthinking your food choices. If you're stressed about your bloating is gonna get worse. If you're stressed about your food, your bloating is gonna get worse. If you're stressed about your husband, your bloating's gonna get worse. As we talked about earlier, the gut is the second brain, and no matter what you're stressed about, whether it be food, money, job, whatever it is, the body's gonna react to that because the sympathetic nervous system, as we said before, it says, time for me to do my job. Blood is flowing away from the digestive system because there are other things that we gotta focus on. So de-stress, my honeys. All right, my honeys, I hope that you found something in here that could be the cause of your bloating. I covered a lot, and if you're still watching, you are a head honey. So comment head honey because you're joining the head honeys. You're not just a healthy honey, you are the head of all the healthy honeys. Comment head honey if you made it to the end of this video. I love you guys, and I'll see you in my next one. Woo!